Very vivid, but the picture is there. You have three distinct mental pictures, and however hard you try, you can never superimpose those three pictures and create one. There'll ever be three in your mind. But when I ask you how many pictures you see, you say one. You are lying to me. Brothers and sisters, you are lying to me.
He prayed in the name of Mohammed. Come out of him. I ask you, what happened? Nothing. He prayed several times in the name of Mohammed, come out of him. Nothing. And I do not mean that disrespectfully of Mohammed. He could have prayed in the name of Abraham or Moses, and it would have done no better. He could have prayed in the name of Paul or Peter, and it would have done no better. So standing there alone, he says, I think I'll try it. My Christian friend has said it. I don't believe it, but I'm going to try it. He laid hands on him. In the name of Jesus Christ, come out of him. He said, Brother Swaggart, before my eyes, he was delivered by the power of Almighty God. I know that you do not deny the miracles of Jesus. But I remind you, as I close this, a dead man cannot produce miracles.
With 2,000 years of preaching, look at it. You have these powers of miracle working. Christ gives life. He heals the sick. Muhammad couldn't. In the name of Muhammad, they couldn't do it. I says, my brothers, you don't read the scriptures. Jesus Christ, he said, for there shall arise many false Christs and false prophets who will show you great signs and wonders if it were possible to deceive the very elect. If false Christ can do that, if false Christ can perform miracles, if false prophets can perform miracles, then I says, is this a test of your faith? No. Then Jesus Christ tells those who are doing this miraculous work, he's telling you in the Gospel of St. Matthew, that on that day, on the last day, on the day of judgment, he says, many will come to me on that day, saying, Lord, Lord, did we not prophesy in thy name, and in thy name cast out devils, and in thy name do many mighty works? In your name, in the name of Jesus, didn't you do all these things? Didn't we do all that? He said, yes. He said, then I will profess unto them, I never knew you. Depart from me, ye that work iniquity. I said, yeah, explain. You. He won't tell the Jews, depart from me. For sake, get away, I don't know you. He won't tell the Hindus, get away from me. Or the atheists, get away from me. He will tell you. I want to know why. Why would he tell you? I don't even know you, get out. I says, look. These are not the tests. John the Baptist, according to Jesus, one of the mightiest messengers of God, Jesus says, among those born of women, there has not risen another greater than John the Baptist, and yet he performed no miracles. Did he? Show me. What did he do? What miracles? No, miracle is not a test. But the greater miracle is that without any miracles, you transform nations. Nations are transformed. 1,000 million people, they don't imbibe alcohol because of the dictates of Muhammad.
Learned that Muslims are some of the most hospitable people on the face of the earth. And I've learned that you are extremely, totally dedicated and serious about your faith. In other words, it's not just a sham with you. You mean business.
Jesus said, by the fruits you shall know them. Do men gather figs from the thistle or grapes from the thorn? He said, every good tree will be a good fruit and every evil tree will be an evil fruit. Here is the test.
He said, come unto me all ye that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn of me, for I'm meek and lowly in heart, and you shall find rest unto your souls. One day, very soon, you see, He's promised to come back. He's coming. Because He said He would come. Every single prophecy in this book that is supposed to be fulfilled has been fulfilled. The others that have not yet been fulfilled will be fulfilled. There is a hunger in the heart of every person for God. Only Jesus Christ can fill that hunger.
You see, Jesus Christ, when He sent out His disciples on the mission of preaching and healing, He instructed them. He said, "Go ye not into the way of the Gentiles, and into any city of the Samaritans enter ye not. But go ye rather unto the lost sheep of the house of Israel." I want to know where the American Anglo-Saxons fit in as the Jews, the house of Israel. Then He's telling a Jewish woman, a Greek woman comes to Him wanting her daughter to be healed. So He turns His face away. She goes on the other side and she won't let Him go. So the disciples say, "Help her, this woman is persistent." You know, like a drowning man clutching at straws, drowning women do the same. Heal her child. So Jesus says, "I am not sent but unto the lost sheep of the house of Israel," the Jews. So they say, "Help her." Jesus says, "Do not throw the bread of the children to the dogs." Who are the dogs? The Gentiles, you and me. Every other human being other than the Jews are dogs and pigs, according to Jesus, or according to your scripture. It says, Jesus says, "Do not throw that which is holy unto dogs. Do not throw pearls before swine, lest they turn and rend you." Who are the dogs and who are the swine? The Gentiles. So He says, "Do not throw the bread of the children to the dogs." The woman in desperation, her child's life is at stake. She says, "Lord, Master, even the dogs have crumbs from the Master's table." So He said, "Give her the crumbs." Look, this is the scripture. Unfortunately, the scripture is not being quoted. The scripture quote what Jesus said. I'd like to hear what Jesus said. Jesus says, not about this supposed idea that you just believe and you be saved. He said, "Verily, verily, I say unto you, except your righteousness exceed the righteousness of the scribes and the Pharisees, you shall by no means enter the kingdom of heaven." There's no heaven for you unless you are better than the Jew. And I'm asking, how can you better than the Jew by not keeping the laws and the commandments? You answer that.